This goes on till chapter 3 and verse 10. Or how about verse 9? Verse 9. Paul concludes the argument that he's been giving us in chapter 2. And I'm sorry I ran out of time, don't have enough time to read the whole thing to you. But in chapter 3, verse 9, here's how it concludes. By reading this conclusion, we can understand the point he's making through everything else in between. Verse 9 says this, "What then? Are we better than they? No, in no wise. For we have before proved, both Jews and Gentiles, that they are all under sin. As it is written, there's none righteous, no, not one." Now, we started this little conversation by saying that the wrath of God, or the punishment of God, is revealed from heaven against all unrighteousness of men. Now, when Paul began to say that, he knew that what we would say is, yes, those rotten people over there, there are some really rotten people in the world, and they're going to get what's coming to them, all right. But see, what he has done in chapter 2, and in the beginning of chapter 3 up until now, and this sums it up in case we missed it, is to prove to all of his readers that we are all in the same boat with them. That everybody, maybe we haven't done as bad of things as some other people have done, but we don't escape just because we haven't done what they have done, even though that's the way humanly we like to speak. Why is he saying all this? He wants everybody, he wants all of us to know that we all need what Jesus is offering. So he sums it up by saying, "As it is written, there's none righteous, no, not one." Now, by the way, that's kind of all-inclusive. What Paul has done is made it universal. He's included everyone. None means nobody. That means nobody's good enough. See, we hold certain people up and say, well, you know, certain people, they are really holy. You know, like Billy Graham, you know, and I admire Billy Graham. Or like Mother Teresa or the Pope or somebody like that. We hold certain people up and put them in high esteem. But Paul here is saying everybody's in the same boat. There's none righteous, no, not one. By righteous, he means nobody measures up to what God requires. That's what righteous means. Nobody measures up. There's none that understands. There's none that seeks after God. They're all gone out of the way. By the way, these are all quotes from the Psalms. They're altogether become unprofitable. There's no one that does good. No, not even one. Their throat is an open sepulcher. Their tongues they have used deceit. Poison of asps is under their lips, whose mouth is full of cursing and bitterness. Their feet are swift to shed blood. Destruction and misery are in their ways. The way of peace they have not known. There's no fear of God before their eyes. Now, summing it up, verse 19. We know that what things soever the law says, it says to those that are under the law. For what purpose? That every mouth might be stopped, and all the world become guilty before God. Well, what a dreadful thing. Why would the goal be to make all the world guilty before God? Well, here's why. By making all the world guilty before God, then he can have mercy on everybody alike. That's what he's getting ready to say. And let's get that and conclude on a positive note. Verse 20. Therefore, by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified in his sight. For by the law is the knowledge of sin. Verse 21. But now, the righteousness of God, or we could say it this way, being right with God, or we could say it this way, being in compliance with the standard of what's right, being in compliance with what God requires, the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all and upon all them that believe. For there's no difference. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. You know, everybody knows verse 23, all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Not everybody notices verse 22, the end of it goes with it. The reason he says verse 23 is because he says there's no difference, for all have sinned. Now, I might not have done as bad of things as some other people did, and somebody else might not have done the things I did, but Paul here says all have sinned, and because all have sinned, there's no difference. I remember myself. I remember the first time, you know, I told you about I used to go with Merlin Booty to BJCC and have a Bible study. I remember the very first time we ever did that. And I was really, just like I told you before with that other story about the demon-possessed son, I was really afraid because I've never been incarcerated. I've never been in jail. And I thought to myself before going there, how can I talk to these guys? I can't identify with them. I've never, you know, had their experience. You know, I'm thinking to myself, you know, they're in some different category. How can I go into these hardened jailbirds, you know? How can I go and say anything to them? Because I don't know what their experience is. I've never been arrested. I've never been incarcerated. I've never been in jail. That's what I'm thinking in my mind. And I tell you, the most amazing thing, how God's able to work. This very scripture came to mind. I knew verse 23. If you'd asked me, what is Romans 3:23? Say, I could have told you, because I knew that. I didn't know that verse 22 went with it. But that verse came into my mind, not consciously knowing it. There is no difference, for all have sinned. That verse came in. There is no difference. And here's what the Lord shared with me. The same things that helped you will help them. because there's no difference. Because even if you haven't done the same things they've done, we're all in the same boat, you see. And everything that I have found out from the Scripture that's helped me to live successfully as a Christian, that's what they need too. And that's what everybody needs. We need Jesus, and that's the thing we need. And let me just read a couple more, and then I'm done. Let's see now, where was I? There's no difference, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And then there's a semicolon, meaning I'm going on here. Being justified freely. Now, the word justified comes from the word just, which comes from, it's the same Greek word translated righteous. To be justified means to be made right, to be made righteous. Being made righteous, notice the next word, freely. Do you know what freely means? What do you think freely means? Here's what I say it means, with no charge, or with no strings attached. With no strings attached. That is so unlike what we think in the religious part of our minds. We attach so many conditions and so many strings to things. But you see, the redemption of Christ, the redemption that God offers us, the righteousness He offers us, is so free and so filled with grace. There are no strings attached. He doesn't say, well, I'll give it to you, but if you don't live up to it, I'll jerk it back away from you. That's what a lot of people think, you know. Then it wasn't free, if it's like that. And it wasn't really given. It wasn't really a gift. It wasn't really given if it's jerked back again. So it says, justified freely, made righteous freely by His grace through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God hath set forth to be a propitiation through faith in His blood, to declare His righteousness for the remission of sins that are past through the forbearance of God, meaning the sins that were committed in the past before Christ. To declare, I say, at this time, His righteousness, that He might be just and the justifier of him that believes in Jesus. Verse 27. Where is boasting then? It is excluded. In other words, what do we have to boast about? Well, the truth is, we don't really have anything to boast about at all, except Jesus. See, I don't have anything to boast about. I can't say, well, just look at me and just do what I've done and just be as good as me and then you'll be okay. All I can tell you is you just need Jesus just like I need Jesus. And just like I need Jesus, everybody needs Jesus. And we've all got Jesus alike. And what I think is, even though we're all different and the circumstances of our life are all different, Jesus knows us all as individuals and He's able to make things right with each one of us because it's all about Him and not about us. That's good enough for today. Let's all stand up. Jesus!